Welcome back to more Game of Thrones. We're just inside the thing's room. What did you call it? I've forgotten the name now. In King's Landing. Someone's just knocked on the door and we're going to find out who it is. So let's continue on.
One moment.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine.
Make sure to tell me. No.
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you all right? If you don't mind my asking, you seem rather upset.
I'm fine.
Thank you.
Of course, m'lady.
How did I avoid his question?
Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady. You work for Lady Marjorie? I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
Perhaps you should come back later.
Of course, m'lady.
Yeah. Come back later. Because to be honest, I've forgotten what happens now. Even though I've seen the TV show, I can't remember. Ah, Hugo.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss.
What's that then?
From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
You're very kind, my lady.
Of course, Mira. But you must not despair. We will get through this together. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself. Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
I'm not a traitor.
Of course not. It's only an excuse to torment you and, by extension, me. She demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort. For what, I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
What do I say?
Find a way to appease her. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear.
Well, this is gonna go well. I can already see it.
See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us.
He's just like looking, what the fuck?
You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Well?
Good luck.
Ooh, it's the Iron Throne.
You can do this.
Uh-oh. Something bad's gonna happen. Look at him, look at him. Look at him, man. Look how small he is. No offense.
Lady Marjorie. Aren't you like looking him. Lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace?
With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
I am honored, Your Grace.
Yet not honored enough to kneel, I see.
Well, excuse
house
me.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl.
Oh no, what do I say?
Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is. The girl can speak for her house.
Yes, Your Grace. To the one true king.
The one true king. Yet she didn't say which. The girl is
I
clever.
I know which one I mean.
She only meant...
I don't care what she meant. I care what she said. I won't stand for impertinence from a girl of the North.
If you would give her the chance to explain...
Perhaps she can explain why the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark for centuries. A house of traitors.
They are noble, not traitors, Your Grace.
Noble? Perhaps once. For a northern house. But now... Now they're merely dead. Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Yes, Your Grace. Absolutely.
That one.
I see. Despite the fact Roose Bolton allied with Walder Frey. If it was me, I'd find it difficult to so quickly forgive the men who killed my father. Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies.
Oh, Joffrey, man, that guy.
I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
There are limits, Your Grace.
Perhaps, but not if your house faces potential ruin.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
She was just following her heart, Your Grace.
And the very same heart so quickly led her to my son.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she
would... Let the girl answer the question. Go on.
I would be true to the king, Your Grace.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she?
The most dangerous handmaid
in all of King's Landing.
I'm not quite sure what to make of her. Not surprising, I suppose, for a northern girl. But not very encouraging either. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
Well, that could have gone better.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
That certainly took courage, to so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Marjorie was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I was trying to appease her.
I think that was clear to everyone. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
What are you suggesting?
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Marjorie might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous. In fact, forget I even suggested such a thing.
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion.
Yeah.
Please.
Sack it.
You are a brave girl, aren't you?
Let's see what happens.
I'll consider it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight.
Yeah, three drink
beautiful
more of that
bottles
wine.
Of Dornish wine await my arrival.
I hope we meet again.
Nothing would make Cersei happier. Until then, be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Where's this kid Joffrey anyway? I want to slap him one man. He's well annoying. Where is he? I want to lump him.
Mira, I was worried. How was it?
Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing.
Not so great for me.
Didn't go very well.
I'm sorry. Cersei is known for being rather difficult. But at least it's over now. Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back, here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jamie,
yeah.
I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white coat.
Yeah, I know what happens here.
What?
Yeah.
It's true.
I'm not going to ruin it, but I know what happens.
Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour, which I doubt is Dornish for life.
But we'll get us into trouble.
We're just having some fun. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him.
Look.
And he's always treated Lady Marjorie well.
Nah.
I'd be willing to marry
him. I know who he is.
But not Joffrey.
Yeah.
Well, I would marry him.
Imagine
the power you would have.
No, you would not want to marry him. Trust me on that one.
I might even allow you to be my handmaiden.
No.
Let's see. Who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match. Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing?
Right, I'm going to end the video here before we move on. Hope you liked the video. There's quite a lot of dialogue in this game, so sorry I didn't talk very much. And if you liked the video, hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more of this series. Peace out.